Let's say you join a government company, and there is again one more claim done by a competitor of Nestle that they are still seeing that Nestle is using more than 2.5 mm of lead in the packet. So the maximum possible limit is this, but somebody is complaining that it is much more than that. Now, what you will do, you cannot just immediately take an action on Nestle just based on a complaint. So you would like to do a sampling test, what you have just learned. So let's say you took a sample of 100 packets and you saw that you got the mean of 2.6 ppm of the package, the lead content. Now definitely it is higher, but no need to worry. We have to look at the basically the tail test and see that how it works. Definitely it's a one tail test because we are talking about max value here. Now let's say we also figured out that my standard deviation for this is 0.6. These are the standard numbers what you already know. But since this is a very critical thing, we want to only reject in 3% of the cases, because definitely we don't want a company to shut down based on just a small mistake. So we would like to, let's say, consider the 3% of basically only in 3% of the case we are going to reject our null hypothesis. So what will be a null hypothesis? The null hypothesis is going to be that your lead contents is less than or equal to 2.5%, and your H1 alternate hypothesis is going to be that it's greater than 2.6 ppm. It's a one tail test, we have already seen it. So what is going to be a value? Now it's not going to be 0.950, because 0.950 for one tail test was there if the alpha was 5%. But here we have taken alpha as 3%. That means we have to take 0.970. Right? So this will be the value which we gonna basically be taking up. Now if you go and look at the jet table for it, you will get this value 1.88. Now you can do that easily on your own and plug into this formula. We will get 2.5 as the mean value which we had, 1.88 what we calculated, jet c, and again 0.6 is the standard deviation and 100 was sample. So you will get 2.61, a big relief sign for Nestle, don't you think so? Because we 2.6 was what we got, and which is less than this value of critical region, so they got saved by this. If we would have maybe increased my significance to 0.5, it could have been a different result. So because of 3% thing, we end up with 2.6, so we failed to reject our null hypothesis. So we will not take any action on Nestle.